Welcome on board. Yeah, from the upstairs you can see everything. You can see this part being, fixed, being worked on because they told us there's gold inside. So we're still looking for gold. No, we're gonna fix it, expand it, develop it and everything. And this part over here, to the right side, used to be a cemetery back then in the middle of the 19th century. We have quite a few monuments to honor, you know, the Queen Victoria with the lion, the horse for the Canadians who lost their lives in the Boers War in South Africa, the first French Prime Minister of Canada, facing the English Prime Minister of Canada from the other side of the street. Quelques monuments pour honorer bien sûr les soldats canadiens, d'accord, le Premier ministre du Canada et le Premier ministre anglophone aussi de l'autre côté parce que celui-là est francophone, et pour honorer le jubilé d'or de la Reine Victoria. Voilà, c'est un cimetière autrefois, mais là, bien sûr, c'est le cœur palpitant de la ville de Montréal. C'est le centre-ville. Et voilà, vous avez Marie-Reine du Monde en face de vous. C'est une basilique, une cathédrale catholique ici, dans le secteur protestant de la ville de Montréal, lorsqu'elle a été construite en 1894. Ladies and gentlemen, Mary, the Queen of the World, on the right-hand side over here, replica of St. Peter's in Rome. It's a Roman Catholic Church, as you see it. Built in the Protestant area of the city of Montreal when it was built back then in 1894 by the second bishop of the city, Monseigneur Ignace Bourget. Le fondateur était le deuxième évêque de la ville de Montréal, Monseigneur Ignace Bourget. Vous avez l'hôtel Reine Marie-Reine, l'hôtel Elisabeth ici, construit en 1958. Ladies and gentlemen, the hotel over here, built in 1958 with 1,034 rooms. Part of the underground city.
Oh, yeah,
you know. Here you go. And be linked to the other side of the building. On this one over here, shaped just like a cross. Alors, le Reine Elisabeth, relié avec la tour Ville-Marie. D'accord? Ils font partie de la première, si vous désirez, section du Montréal souterrain ou de la ville souterraine. Faut pas oublier la ville souterraine si jamais c'est trop chaud pour vous. Et c'est humide, et vous désirez aller découvrir la ville souterraine. Si jamais vous restez avec le tour en long de, bien sûr, du tour, on va vous indiquer d'autres tronçons du Montréal souterrain. On va vous dire comment aller dans la ville souterraine. Ladies and gentlemen, if you stay with us enough for the next 2 hours, I will show you more portion sections of the underground city. And we'll let you know how to reach out for the underground city later. Very easy, very easy. Traffic is smooth and it's good this morning. You know, it's Saturday. Not bad. Yeah. People are taking the day off slowly. We're still on vacation, by the way. Schools are still on vacations. University are still on vacations. We're still enjoying the summertime. And that's why we don't have that many people in the streets. We will have this. Don't worry, my friend. Ne vous inquiétez pas, il va y avoir du monde. Regardez sur la droite ici, vous avez le bureau ici. Les Jeux Olympiques de Montréal avec les anneaux, les 5 anneaux qui représentent les 5 continents. Just ladies and gentlemen, passing the Olympic, you know, Games Office of Montreal, you've got the St. Patrick Basilica over here. There's you could see it from here. Take a look at this, built in 1847. But the construction, of course, started before, 20 years before. C'est la Valin avec la signature sur le gazon que vous voyez, mesdames et messieurs. Ça c'est une compagnie de génie. Ils ont des contrats à travers le monde. Ils ont plus que 5000 employés. SNC Lavalin, the signature on the brass, ladies and gentlemen, on the left hand side. It's a company, you know, specializing in engineering, and they've got contracts all over the world. They're into tunnels and bridges and airports. They've got a lot of contracts in Africa. Founded by a Swiss gentleman back then when he built it, when he started in 1959. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be in the government buildings area of the city. Sur la gauche, vous avez l'immeuble le plus laid de la ville de Montréal, c'est l'immeuble d'imposition. It is done too. Ladies and gentlemen, the building on the left hand side is the ugliest building of the city. It's the taxation building, the income tax building. No, it's nice, it's cute. There you go. Take a look at even the rainbow of Desjardins. Yeah, they made it in a beautiful colors, rainbow. Regardez le complexe Desjardins ici sur la gauche, c'est un grand mall. Ladies and gentlemen, take a look at the second portion of the underground city over here, ladies and gentlemen, where the IGA is located. Complex Desjardins, linked to this one on the right hand side over here. It's called Complex Guy Favreau. As you see, it's Complex Guy Favreau. And they're all parts of the second portion of the underground city. La deuxième section du Montréal souterrain is ici. The building on the right side is for the Canadian citizenship and the Canadian passport and the immigration courts and so on, you know, and it's all, you know, they have all the old joints all together. In case you want to be in the underground city, it's worth it. The IGA, the Independence Grocers Alliance, ladies and gentlemen, they succeeded in Quebec, you know. They've been opening franchises all over the Quebec province.
Windows, I think so.
Yeah.
Not a job.
Oh, they're not the
reading
in the face.
Not the
reading. I don't wish
you watch. No.
Le quartier chinois, ici, vous avez de la Crochetière, c'est une zone piétonnière qu'on va traverser tout de suite. Ladies and gentlemen, Chinatown over here, the pedestrian walkway de la Crochetière, exactly where we are now. Take a look at the left side, it's warming up, Chinese pastries are here, the Chinese restaurants, Chinese, if you want to dine and wine, okay, it's the best place where to be. Chinese people that came to Canada to work in mines and built the Canadian railways back then. It's a small Chinatown because the expansion was limited by the construction of the government buildings. L'expansion du quartier chinois était limitée par le développement et la construction des immeubles gouvernementaux ici. Là, en direction, mesdames et messieurs, du Vieux Montréal. Le Vieux Montréal à deux pas d'ici, par exemple. Ladies and gentlemen, our first, you know, stop is coming up now. Right in the corner after this one. If you want to go to the Basilica Notre Dame, it's two steps away from here, over the hill. And you are at the Basilica Notre Dame. It's cost $6 to go in, by the way. Okay, madame. Hello. How many people are you? Oh, you bought here from the press cafe. Alright, that's okay. You are with us now. We love you and we cherish you. I don't know if we have a... Wait, is he with you, this gentleman? No. Okay. Hopefully you have a seat upstairs. Slowly, Karim, doucement, parce que le monsieur n'a pas trouvé d'espace. Because he couldn't find seats upstairs. You will get seats, trust. Allez. Ok, vas-y, il n'y a plus d'espace ici, on ne peut plus. Ok, hello, no more seats upstairs. No more seats upstairs. Please, be my guest. Good morning. How are you guys? All right. No, I don't need to see anything, enjoy the ride. Somebody will come take care of that business. I don't put my hand where they don't belong. I don't want to be, you know, in me. Okay, Fox.
Alors, mesdames et messieurs, on va continuer à naviguer à travers le Vieux-Montréal. Bien sûr. Là, on va traverser de l'ouest vers l'est de la ville de Montréal. Et sur la ville, il va y avoir le quartier chinois.
We're going to be hidden from the west where we are. This is the end of the west side of the city of Montreal. And the minute we cross this boulevard over here, that is called the Boulevard Saint-Laurent, we're going to be in the east side of the city of Montreal. Take a look out to the left, please. Chinatown, here, here. There's your left, my friend. Here you go.
Centre Hospitalier Universitaire de Montréal. If you read it from the right to the left, it will give you the Montreal University Health Center. Yeah, because here we read French from the right to the left, from the left to the right. It's a wake-up call. This couple is so sleepy. Good morning. Mademoiselle, bonjour.
She's a woman, a hard-working woman. They never get a bed. We used to take a nap in the afternoon.
Yeah.
The National Assembly taking a nap. There you go, the city hall. You could see the beautiful design of grass over here. 185 for the first elections of the city. It's 1833. Voilà. L'hôtel de ville d'où le général de Gaulle avait déclaré vive le Québec libre en 1967. Voilà. And take a look out to the left side. The square Jacques Cartier. Or Jimmy Carter Square. Choose in between. Pick up your choice. Multiple choices, madame. Here. It's nice. It's not bad. Jarvis, don't look at it like this. It's waking up, you know. Give it some time. The square has been drinking all night long. Yeah, it has a hangover. Come on. Well, I'm exploring the city hall. Come on, the pavilions, you know. Over here, tickets, you know. Spending our taxes. Lovely people. The appeal court house, we just pass it. There we go, the first house is coming up on the right side over here. Okay. Hopefully we're going to see some beautiful brides today, some good weddings. Oh yes, nice gowns. Are you married, mademoiselle? Are you married? Good, because we renewed the vows over here in Montreal. Congratulations. All right, here's the Boulevard Saint-Laurent, ladies and gentlemen. If you would like to have smoked meat today, the steamed meat, the good meat, the best that is from the city, go to Schwartz, it's up north of the Boulevard Saint-Laurent. Over here, up north, not a little bit. You have to take a cab. We're not, we don't drive by there. Just in case, we just want to let you know. Or you could have smoked meat downtown. We have another location. But this is the best of all of them. Okay. All right, guys. Boulevard Saint-Laurent. Take a look at the street names. They're in red. It means you are in the old Montreal. And with the pickup whites, you went out from the old town. Alors, mesdames et messieurs, le Boulevard Saint-Laurent va traverser de l'est, pardon, de nouveau vers l'ouest. En descendant ici, en tournant à droite tout à l'heure. This is a charming street, Boulevard Saint-Laurent and Saint-Paul. Remember the location, please, if you want to go and browse, you know. And maybe, I don't know, French restaurants, we have them here. If you are craving for French restaurant tonight, it's Saturday, you want to room, you want to have some good times, you want to spend your money, you want to open your heart, you want to open your wallet. Okay, here you go. Take a look at to the left side, please. It's another pedestrian walkway. We've seen two up now. We've seen in Chinatown, pedestrian walkway, and this is the second one in the Old Montreal, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, it will get busy later on. Voilà, on va aller en direction maintenant. On est en face, bien sûr, du Centre des sciences de Montréal. It's a museum about science. If you are interested in touring the place. And step number two is coming up. By the St. Lawrence River, by the way. Okay, Fox. Just in front of you, across the street from here, you have the Archaeology and History Museum, La Pointe Bacalière. Second stop. Arrêt numéro 2, mesdames et messieurs. Voilà, c'est chouette. Uh-oh. If somebody comes out, it's your turn to go upstairs. By the way, it's good for 2 days. We don't have the one-day tickets. Sorry. I don't design anything. Don't blame it on me. Blame it on the young engineer. Don't look at me. I'm just the speaker of the house. Ladies and gentlemen, take a look at to the right side. At the bottom of the story, we miss it. That was the foundation of the city of Montreal. Back then, when it was built in 1642, I'm speaking about the basement of the Archaeology and History Museum that is called La Pointe Calière, Calière Museum. Remember, if you are here, you want to see something different, you feel like an archaeologist, okay, you want to find some, find out about artifacts, go to the museum over here. Or go to the Pont Secours Marcus if you want to become a deputy. Used to be the Parliament of Canada. And you could pretend you are the deputy of Canada. Why not, my friend? Go to the Pont Secours Chapel if you want to see the panoramic views of the St. Lawrence River. That's a charming view. Pont Secours Chapel. It's right here. It's in the old Montreal. It's not far from here. Speaking about the location and site nearby, I'm not speaking about anything, you know, that is located in Jamaica. Okay? All right, guys. Okay, c'est bon. Alors, je parlais bien sûr des sites qui se trouvent à proximité d'ici. You could go cruising on St. Lawrence River. Patomosh is nice. Patomosh, one of the charming cruises we have. Or you could go on St. Paul Street and go to the that famous souvenir shop that sells the, you know, that's writing that says, all my fox went to Montreal and all of that, these lousy t-shirts. Buy that t-shirt. Not expensive, $5. Okay, folks, voilà. Uniquement pour vous en occuper, uniquement si jamais vous désirez aller quelque part dans le Vieux-Montréal, vous avez beaucoup de choses quand même. Il y a la plage Jacques-Cartier, qu'il faut toujours l'indiquer avec la rue Saint-Paul, qu'il faut aller voir de temps à autre. Les croisières cette semaine sont pas là. Hein. Les gros bateaux. Here you go, charming terrasse, voilà. This is a famous breakfast place, by the way, on the left side. Very famous. Yeah. They sell a lot of eggs.
Mon coco.
Mon coco. This is this is McGill Street, ladies and gentlemen. For the new people, you just came in over here, ladies and gentlemen. The red streets names on the street light that you see over there, they're red because you are still in the old Montreal. William and Ruth McGill. And on the right hand side, you're gonna see a central building that is a history museum of Montreal. Le Musée used to be a firefighters in our station. Right on the right side, here. Coming up, here's the building. You can see it. Voila! If you wanna learn, if you feel like a historian, you wanna learn about the city and the foundation of the city back then in the middle of the 17th century. C'est le Musée d'Histoire de la Ville de Montréal. That's a nice, charming hotel, so cool. Not bad, it used to be a big warehouse. Then somebody bought it and converted some nice hotel. Most of the buildings that you see over here on the right and the left are from the late 18th century and the 19th century. It is a Valier French restaurant. Fish and chips, the best in town. On the right, fish and chips. Don't look for another one, this is the best. I'm telling you, have you been there? Not yet? Oh, this is a good one, trust me, it's a good one. Merci beaucoup. Well, because it's Saturday, you need to know where to be. Exactly, McGill Street, McGill Street. Mesdames et messieurs, on est sur la rue McGill. On va en direction du quartier financier de la ville de Montréal. See the changes of colors, the street names? They're in red, now they're becoming white. It is one of the front is red, the other one is, the other side is white. Where Notre Dame Basilica is located on this street. The Basilica in a Gothic revival in our style. You have to go to see the Basilica Notre Dame if you weren't there, if you are into, you know, beautiful churches. Here, the business district, the stock exchange market on the left hand side, ladies and gentlemen. The tower. It's our Wall Street, and it linked to the World Trade Center on the right side, le Centre de Commerce Mondial. Les deux reliés, la tour de la Bourse de la Ville de Montréal sur la gauche, reliés avec le Centre de Commerce Mondial. This is the another section, ladies and gentlemen, of the underground city. In case you are here and you want to go, you want to look around, that's a charming mall on the right side. Beautiful, but very clean. Voilà. Une autre section du Montréal souterrain, l'entrée parisienne sur la gauche, plus loin, du métro. You could see a Parisian fence. We are seeing Metropolitan within the trees and the water. That's a Parisian entrance to the metro like you are in Paris. Farther up on the left side. Farther up after the light, after the light. Sur la droite. All the World Trade Center, you can see the name on the right hand side now. Le Centre de Commerce Mondial. That's your first word in French, the World Trade Center. There is another one coming up. They're all together in one section. The convention center on the left side in the corner with the multiple colors, ladies and gentlemen. Built in 1983 and restored in 2002. It has over 65 meeting rooms. Mesdames et messieurs, le Palais des Congrès de la Ville de Montréal, sur la gauche, dans le coin. Construit en 1983 et restauré en 2002. Quand même, il est grandiose. Plus que 65 chambres. Si vous voulez, salle de réunion. Voilà, des hôtels de luxe ici, qu'on est en train de longer. Bien sûr, parce qu'il y a le palais des congrès de Montréal, quand même, le centre de commerce mondial et la tour de la beauté de la ville de Montréal, et le centre financier de la ville, etc. Alors, les gens, ils ont besoin, les gens d'affaires et les gens d'affaires ont besoin de d'hébergement. Et des hôtels de Maroc, c'est une grande chose qu'on a skirting over here. All part of the business district at the city. Arrêt numéro 1 de nouveau. Stop number 1, we've done it before. And we're doing it again. Representing tourists and a Montreal skating. Skating by, yeah, that's an honor, a gift from the city of Paris to the city of Montreal for the 375 years of the anniversary of the city. Again, we're heading from the west to the east, and Chinatown Gateway is on the left side. Brand new hospital, the brand new buildings on the left side are in Saint-Champs. We've seen it before. Multiple buildings representing the big hospital. It's part of the French-speaking university, the Université de Montréal, which was reminded of the park. Almost 800 beds, as well as the nurses, the certificate for that. If you're a dog, we'll make you an offer you can't refuse. How about that? Le centre hospitalier avec 900 docteurs, presque 800 lits et au-delà de 1200 infirmières. Ça nous a coûté à peu près 1 milliard et demi. Il nous coûte like 1 million and a half to the taxpayer. Ladies and gentlemen, the bridge of Cartier is in front of you. Yeah? If you were upstairs, you would see it clearly. Then keep the island of Montreal to South Shore. From the edge of the bridge of Cartier, we've been watching the finale of the Fire International Firework competition on Wednesday night. Le pont Jacques-Cartier qui le relie l'île de Montréal avec la rive sud. Bien sûr, il y a beaucoup d'autres ponts. Et il y a aussi des tunnels. Il y a aussi le métro qu'il ne faut pas oublier. Got the building over here, it is a building with the antennas on the roof. That's the CBC, the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation. Stop number 3 is coming up. Sorry. Yeah, sure. Yeah, 1 minute. Arrêt numéro 3. Ça sent bien.
he's gonna go across. What's it, sink yet?
Yeah, this is not the stop point here, not yet. Pas encore, madame, please. We don't guarantee anything here. It's dangerous. Number 3.
It's kind of nice right here.
Yeah.
Number 3 sitting on the
wheel.
Well, we should do the whole thing, right? We should do the whole thing.